is Matthew. I'm going to talk to you about losing an eye and obtaining a prosthetic eye for the first time and what to expect. I was born with a congenital cataract, which led to me losing the vision in my left eye. They had to remove my lens, which ultimately left me with no vision. I was 3 years old when I lost my vision, so I do not remember seeing out of both eyes. My adaptability after that was very easy for me, so that part of losing an eye is a little different with me. I never struggled adapting. At the age of 3, I was diagnosed with glaucoma after my cataract, and I battled glaucoma to the age of 11, where ultimately they had to remove my eye because the pressure behind my optic nerve was so acute that it literally was going to destroying everything in my eye. They ultimately decided to remove it. I was 11, so at that time I was very accepting of this. My parents were not. I just didn't really understand the full outcome and what I'd have to deal with later on in life. After the eye removal, the healing process took quite a while. I want to say it was probably 3 weeks till I was actually feeling somewhat better. You know, the muscles in your eye, you have so many. They're in unison with your other eye, so every time this eye moves, you know, these muscles want to move. So I remember after the surgery, I didn't want to move my eye because these muscles always tried to move. So I was very limited in my motion for a while. It took me about 3 weeks till I came back. After the healing, my hero, Mr. Greg Dudes, basically saved my life. I mean, he made everything better. I met Greg right before the enucleation, and he basically explained to us that after this whole surgery, we're going to start the process of making your prosthetic after you're fully healed, and it was a breeze with him. He's extremely detailed, and the whole process probably takes about 2 months. To make the eye itself, probably about 3 weeks. What they do is they take basically a mold of your socket, and from the mold, he shapes it, and he does all the artistry work himself. People could not tell the difference when I originally had my prosthetic, and it made me extremely comfortable, and you know, I knew I could deal with this. And after that whole process, making the prosthetic, after you receive your new prosthetic, it takes time for it to settle and conform into your socket. It's not comfortable at first, you know, you really have to accept what's happening to your socket. You're gonna be in a little bit of pain, you know, you might have some discharge, but more importantly, you have to understand that your eye needs to settle. I wanna say at least a week to feel like you're starting to get there with your comfortability with it, and it may not look great at first because it takes time to settle. So you need to understand that. I was probably good for 11 years where they had to make no edits, no nothing. For that whole stretch, I was great. It doesn't even cross your mind. It's just there. I had no problems whatsoever until as we age, which I'm going through right now, we lose orbital fat. Most of us do around our eye that supports the prosthetic. As I aged, I lost a significant amount, and I started to, you know, it started sinking back, and I was uncomfortable, and I didn't want to wear it, and I didn't. In regards to the surgery too, with the prosthetic, they put it in what's called a ball implant. It could be porous, and it's behind your tissue. It's basically to fill that tissue, what you lost from the removal of your eye, and they attach your eye muscles to this, so you get some movement behind your eye. My tissue was literally, the implant was showing and it was rubbing. So I was getting these abrasions behind my eye, and that's when they ultimately knew they had to put in a new implant. So I had that done actually in Florida when I lived down there for 2 years. Now I was a little bit different. My implant was in for 20 years. They were able to make it work for that long. So the removal of the old implant was, the tissue was so grown in there. So I received a new implant. I'm with that. It filled out the volume of the socket a lot better. The healing process with that was at least a month and a half. That tissue takes a long time to heal back there. With that, you wear a conformer, which I actually have in right now. It's just a clear shell, basically just protects, you know, your tissue, and it blocks particles or anything from getting in. You also want to keep the shape so it holds. If you didn't wear anything in there at all, it would start shrinking and collapse. There's nothing there to hold it. So that's extremely important too. My first prosthetic I had, my actual first prosthetic eye was 11 years. That was a long time too. Greg Deuce was very amazing at adding on where he needed to. Very talented. And then I received my second one that lasted almost another 10 years. Now we are in the transition of my third prosthetic. I'm 34 years old. You have to expect that your eye socket's gonna change, and as you age, you will need to take care of it. There's not much care involved on a day-to-day, but every so often, you may have a burning sensation, or it might be dry, or maybe you suspect there's something behind there that's irritating. I personally, if it's bothering me, I will take it out, I'll clean it. Washing it is important too, it actually like keeps it polished. And then there might be other times that, depending on your environment, that it could be irritating. Maybe you're cooking, smoke, it still can irritate it, you know, stuff like that. So I don't take it out for any other reason. So recently, I just had surgery with Dr. Nelson, and it's called a fat graft, which I was a candidate that was losing my orbital fat around my eye, and because of that, I could not wear my prosthetic. We realized that we needed to add some more tissue in there to hold the prosthetic, and I'm in transition with that right now after the fat graft is healing. Greg Deuce has already looked in there, and he knows what's going on. The healing from the fat graft needs to be readjusted a little bit before he can make the prosthetic. This is my fourth eye, and after this next surgery, Greg will make another prosthetic. I was more like on the extreme sports side. I snowboarded skateboarded my entire life. Being adapted, I really didn't have a problem with my depth recession. I played baseball, I played soccer, I loved snowboarding, I skateboarded for a very long time. You know, it really didn't stop me from doing anything. I did wear safety glasses when I played baseball. I always had glasses on. I realized that having glasses can really balance the proportion, the equalness, the way your eyes look. With glasses, your prosthetic eye, it just looks more normal. Going in to take the drivers, I just told them I had one eye, and they're like, okay. And maybe state to state, it's a little different. I lived in Florida for a little period of time, and because I had one eye, I could not rent a U-Haul. You have to have, in Florida at least, you have to be able to see out of the back of your vehicle. Michigan, that was not the case.